Hi everyone. Welcome to Heather's Art Adventures. I hope you're ready to have some fun. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. I am so glad that you made it. And most of all, I'm glad Jules showed up because this show is very boring with just me talking. I mean, you can experience it over on YouTube right now.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Jules. So you can experience just how annoying it is to listen to just Heather talk if you watch that pre-streaming over there, but... Who do we have over here? Well, Andrew's here. Eight we're watching on the YouTube. When you type that, wow, that's pretty cool. I mean, that's what it says. I doubt it's true, but.
No, there was comments.
Yeah, really? I don't have any comments. I'm still live over there right now. See, I don't have any comments. I don't see any comments on my iPad telling me that people are actually commenting. So I don't be. But I think it's bull. You're lying to me.
Just yeah, because we do that all the time, don't we?
I know you do it all the time. Okay, so you know what? In all of my getting things ready, I forgot totally to get my images for the dogs. The dog I'm going to draw today. You think I would have been prepared?
Why don't you do that? I'll say good morning to Melissa. Good
All
to
right.
see you.
Yay. Yay, Melissa is here. Good morning, Melissa. I'm glad you made it. And that did not work. Okay, let's see. I have to find the right place. This is me on YouTube looking above and below the camera rod that's right in my way. It feels weird because a lot of this stuff, like live here on Twitch, you don't see because the camera is not on my face. But out of the corner of my eye, I see this camera over here watching me. And I know it can see me doing things like if I were to pick my nose right now or who knows what. I wouldn't do that. I'm just saying if I did, you know, that's what I meant.
Well, if needs All right. must.
Yeah, exactly. All right. So...
We also have Michael Ann joining us. Good morning, Michael Ann.
Oh, well, good morning, Michael Ann. I'm so glad you made it as well. Is that because of the live on YouTube? Is that the reason why you're able to make it over here? Like, is that a good indicator to get you over?
It seems to be.
Why can't I find the picture that I had set up for today's drawing? Why can't I find it?
Jane has joined us also. Good morning.
All right, let's see. Jane has joined. She said, Michael Ann says, yes, otherwise I forget. Okay, well. So maybe I will just annoy the heck out of 8,000 subscribers and we'll just end up with like 5 subscribers over on YouTube eventually because... They will be sick and tired of seeing me not go live. Let's see. Okay. I know this is very frustrating because on my phone, it's number one thing, but then over on the desktop, it's not.
Right.
And I lied. There it is. Okay. Never mind. All right. We're good. Whatever. Okay. So this... I think, yeah, so I'm going to do these. Okay. All right. We'll see how this goes. So YouTube, I'm going to say goodbye over there on YouTube and you guys have a crafty day. If you want to join us and see where we go with the drawing for the pastels today, then head on over to Twitch. All right. now that YouTube has ended and you guys can't see me pick my nose anymore over there, then, yeah.
I think when I do my 1 hour countdown for the show, I'm going to have to start tagging people on Instagram.
True. Oh, that's a great idea. I should do something like that because you know what I can do? I can set up an automatic post. Michael Ann, are you on Instagram? Do you get in notifications from Instagram? Because if you do, I could tag, like at mention you in an automated post that goes out before we go live, like 15, 20 minutes before we go live. I could do that. You know what we should, you know what we should do? We should start a list of people who would like to be informed that way. Because I could set up an automated thing that goes out every Monday through Friday when I'm going to go live. And then I can easily go in and cancel that for the day if it isn't going. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I'll get a piece of paper ready for anybody who wants to be in on that.
All right. Thanks, Jules. Okay. So I'm going to leave the words up on screen up there and leave it just like this. I think this is a good Zoom. Until you guys tell me otherwise, this is where we're going to leave the camera. Okay. You guys tell me if it needs to be zoomed in better or anything like that. All right, so there's one. Did I just took the protective sheet off of that one. Dag nabbit. All right, so Mike, here's what we're going to draw on.
Mike Land seems happy for the Instagram shout out.
Oh, cool. All right, I've never wanted to do that because I thought it would be too annoying for people, but then I've also noticed that people are confused as I am about the notifications. So whatever we can do to make life easier.
So I'll put Michael Ann's name on.
And if it's automatic, that works, right? I know, that was funny. All right, let's
Andrew
see.
Says, yes, like my morning reminder.
Yes, exactly.
And Mike Land saying, camera angle looks good on my end. It does look good.
Good. I know that it's a little bit dark, but it's so hard. I mean, with all that rain and everything, I have the window wide open. The window is totally open, but it's as if we have like no light on in the house because it's so dark outside. Okay, I've got a couple pencils.
Once you start putting color on, we'll see what's happening.
Exactly. I've got colored pencils, or these are not colored pencils. These are Derwent pastel pencils. There is a difference, if anybody's wondering. Oops. All right, I've got to get all these sharpened. See, I wasn't prepared. I was too busy doing the goofy live streaming thing. But I don't know how else to help people know where we've gone. Because I've gotten a lot of questions on older videos saying, I've been watching your stuff and it'd be nice if you did some new things. Like, why? I do new stuff every day. Well, I haven't seen any of it. Well, it's on Twitch. Oh, I didn't know you were on Twitch. Which is understandable. Okay. Let's see. So I've got my colors ready. Almost. One more.
I've just put out, say yes if you want an ID shout out, like in the comments.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, Michael Ann's put yes, please. I've got your name down, Michael Ann. Thank you.
Awesome. Like Andrew said, it's just like his morning reminder for those who want to visit the U2U help center. He does a morning reminder over on Hangouts, but I'm not connected to everybody on Hangouts because nobody really uses that very much. So, I mean, nobody in our art community. And we do a daily reminder on the Discord.
Yeah.
But not everybody is on the Discord. So it's like, you know, how do you do it? I don't know. But Instagram, if you're on Instagram, then we'll go ahead and give you a reminder. You just got to leave the comment. Yes, please add me to the Instagram reminder. Okay. One thing I learned drawing Sophie last time is not to use regular drawing pencil on this. Remember, this is Pastel Matte. If you remember, or if you didn't get to see, Pastel Matte is a very different surface, but it's perfect for pastels, soft pastels, hard pastels. And it had a really cool quality about water that was really awesome.
Oh, yeah.
We played with that. There's a whole video on that. I just remembered something else I wanted to share with you guys before I get into that, because I don't want to mess this up. But see this box?
Yeah.
So this box was jam-packed full to the brim of these, and this is all that's left. And these are, remember those purses that we made?
All right, so you have been able to get some made.
Yeah, I made 24 of these little purses. I have three different kinds that I made. If you wanted to see how these were made, we did a video on these too. And then I did 16 of these wallets in different like browns, like dark brown, light brown.
I love them little purses and wallets.
I know, so cool. And I gave all the guys a wallet and all the ladies got to choose a purse. And then in each one, it has a little Merry Christmas card in one side. And then it has one of these Ghirardelli chocolate squares.
Yeah.
On the other side. And that fits in there just perfectly. The way that I have all these dimensions on the Discord, on the Craft With Me thing. So if you watched the video, we made a couple of changes, and then I put all of the final informational doodads, every measurement, every scoring thing. But I put it so that they were like this. So see how they kind of bulge a little bit? Because yeah. Of that chocolate square. But here's the thing, it closes because we added like a little quarter inch gap for these. So it closes real well, stays closed. It's not going to pop open on you. And I used Velcro snaps.
Aren't they great than Velcros?
Yeah, this was really a cool idea. This one is really strong Velcro. I got these ones, this bigger one at Hobby Lobby. And this one is a little bit easier for this particular application. These are smaller. I got these at Walmart.
Right.
So I don't know which one's better. This one definitely holds. Like it's almost impossible to pry it open. Like it's a little
I've
scary.
Got you might rip stronger it. Ones. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So I thought that was totally fun. This one is my favorite. It actually looks like a purse I would carry.
Does.
With the plaid. I think that's cute, but
Michael
anyway.
Says, oh my gosh, so cute.
Yeah, so I made these and I walked around the room and said, choose a ribbon. And when they pulled out a ribbon, it came out with one of those three styles. And then the guys, I was like, take a wallet. One of them pulls a purse. And I said, or a purse if you prefer, whatever. I'm not going to judge. So anyway, he's like, oh, I thought they were all the same, but. Anyway, that was fun. And then the best part about that gift that I wanted them all to know was that it was a gift they can give to someone else. So that's why I didn't write anything in it or make it personal, because I wanted them to be able to share it.
Yep. They're the best ones, the ones you can pass along.
That's what I thought. All right. We're going to use a gray to get started so I can draw my marks. Are you guys ready? I mean, it's like 15 after. Are you guys ready to actually do some work?
Hmm? I think we're just about ready.
All right. Well, then we'll get started. So I have done zero warm up. So I'm going to try really hard to do this without wrecking it.
The That's the beauty of the pastel. You can have you got an eraser close at hand?
Yeah, let's try that because I know that was one thing I didn't test was how well they erase on here. If it erases. Let's see here. Hang on. I have one of these. This should work. This is just a white eraser that I clearly love a great deal. And oh my gosh, does it ever. Look at that. There we go. Okay.
Handy to know. Perfect.
Yep. Okay, so I'm just going to measure with my fingers. Just do it like that. It's about where that goes. Yeah. Okay. Just going to put in lines so I have an idea where we're going. This cute little guy, oh my gosh, looks almost like a little old man right here. Like this is his whiskers. I'm going to do like I did with Jane and not say who it is or who's it for and see if the owner comes to watch, if the owner can recognize who it is. We'll see.
Is this one of the commissions?
No, it is not.
Right. Now I know that. I think I have the feeling whose animal it might be, but I'll not say. I'll put it in the whispers on Twitch.
Oh, will you now? I don't have that open. Do it in the private message here on StreamYard. I have that open. I can see it over here.
I don't know how to do that.
Oh. Do you have private chat over on the very far right hand side?
Oh, yeah, that one.
Okay.
Yeah, I've done it.
Okay, let me look. Let me look and see what she guesses. Nope.
Oh.
Nice try.
There we go. We all need to guess.
Let's see. Just trying to give myself an outline here so I can have a place to start, you know what I mean?
I'm gonna send you another message.
Oh boy, she's just gonna keep guessing. Bring the guesses on. Everybody try to see if they can figure it out.
There we go.
Another one? Okay, I'll look. Nope.
You're not going to tell me if I get it right.
I would too. But I'm not telling them your guesses, so that way they don't know that it's not that and it's not that, so they can guess too. So let's just see how this goes.
Right. They're the only ones I can think of at the moment.
Uh-huh.
Wait till you start filling it in.
Yeah, I do need to start filling it in. Because it's not, I got to get to the point where I feel comfortable. Okay.
Michaelan says, it's looking like a dog to my eyes.
Oh, thank God. It's
definitely going to be a dog.
Thank God it looks like a dog. Because it's always the concern you know. Will it be a dog or not? That is the wrong color. I got to set that one up there because that does not work.
And yes, I am. You're right, Michael, and it's a dog.
Am I right? Yes. Good job, Michael Ann. That's 100 points to Michael Ann for actually knowing that I was drawing a dog. I'm really impressed that I actually was able to pull it off with just the little sketchy, because I didn't feel that way about Sophie's. I'm like, maybe I should tell you guys it is a dog.
No, you could say straight away it was Sophie. Michael Ann saying, woohoo!
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
I'll have to put a scoreboard down now as well.
Scoreboard. I love it.
A cute nose. I might cheat and go into Discord and have a look to see who sent the pets.
Oh, there you go. That's interesting. See if that helps you or not.
To remembering which tab it was in, though.
Yeah, I had to do the same thing, honestly, but good luck with that. All right.
She's some help, isn't she?
Seriously, because I had a hard time. So good luck.
No, you know it's there, but you can't remember which tab it's in, and you've got to go through everything.
Exactly. Of course, doing this means I have to concentrate a great deal because I'm actually trying to draw something that looks like something specific. Whereas usually what I'm trying to draw is an idea of, I just want you to have the impression of, not today. I'd really hope it looks like this. Otherwise the owner is like, yeah, great. Not my dog though.
That's the thing when you do animals.
Well, and they know. I mean, they know if it's, and you know, it's their pet, their family member. They want it to look like their family member.
Yeah. Looking cute.
Nobody wants a picture of somebody else's. Version of their animal. You know, they want it to be. You want to be able to look at it and go, that's my Sophie or whatever.
Yeah.
And as an artist, that was the best feeling in the world, was to have Jane say, oh my gosh, it is my Sophie.
Yeah.
You know, well, I don't know who it is, Heather, but it sure looks an awful lot like my Sophie. Those are the best words ever. Best words ever.
I know that it made you do.
For sure.
I find animals, well, I've never done like for like, but I find them easier to draw than humans.
Really? Now that's an interesting thought. How come? What's your reasoning for that, do you think?
I don't know. I mean, I don't draw faces very often, but I've done a couple of animals this year and I find them a lot easier than when I do human faces. I think I overthink.
Oh, yeah, possible.
Yeah, I tend to do that a lot, especially when I'm doing art. My latest thing is keeping in my head. It's just a piece of paper.
Yeah, that I think is an easy thing to say, but not necessarily an easy thing to live out.
Yeah. It's like when I showed you me sketches I did a few weeks ago on the printer paper.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were just quick. And I flew through them. And I thought, well, why can't I do that on the good paper?
It's well, I think because we're nervous about that. I mean, especially when you are an artist on a budget. When you're an artist on a budget, you're dealing with this is really good paper and or this is a really good canvas or this is really good supply.
Yeah.
You know, and I know I personally, this is just my own personal experience, is that I find myself thinking, well, if I mess this up, I'll have to buy another one. And how long did I wait to buy that one?
Yeah.
You know, and I talk myself out of doing art a great deal because like it was just like this with this paper. You know, this paper is so expensive.
Yeah.
And if you had not bought it for me, it'd probably still be sitting in the package. You know what I mean?
You have to have
I'd be
it.
Too Well, I'd be too afraid to use it is what I mean.
Yeah.
I'd be feeling like it's too special for me to run the risk of wasting. And that in as I'm getting older and figuring things out a little better, that to me is a waste. And it's something we need to help ourselves get over, help each other get over.
Mike Lansing, I'm the opposite. Faces are easier. Painting, drawing fur scares me.
Really?
I find fur quite easy.
Oh, I love fur. I think fur's super easy only because it's just so
random.
Yeah, I think that's what it is. I think because it is so random.
I've never tried to do a like-for-like image. I might have to try that. Like in a person.
Well, I've tried drawing. My cousin passed away a couple years ago.
Right.
And her mom was having a really hard time. So I did a sketch, a black and white sketch of her. Just a picture I saw on Facebook or something.
Yeah.
And she's like, that's really pretty. And I'm thinking, okay, not a great response. Maybe it upset her too much. You know, I just was kind of like, don't let it bother me. So later she said, do you think you could draw one of Lindsay? Like that was Lindsay. I was like, oh, probably not. I'm just gonna go out on a limb here and guess. No, probably I can't.
Yeah. She didn't recognize it.
No.
That must be heartbreaking as well in itself.
Well, it was a little frustrating for me, but I was just like, obviously I didn't grasp it very well, you know, grasp the likeness of her. And that's what I was saying before was that I can probably draw a dog, no problem. I can probably draw a dog that looks very similar to the dog you had you know, whatever. But will I be able to pull off the character of that dog? That's my challenge. And that's what I'm trying to do with these sketches. We'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes.
Whosoever dog it is, it's looking adorable. That eye, it looks so real.
That's good. That's where we want to go with it. It's a little bit of gray in here, but... yeah, you probably can't see that gray very well. I wonder if I can zoom in on this. Since I do have that open, can I zoom in without affecting everything else? There we go. Look at that. Now we'll get to see it a little better.
Look at that eye. Wow.
That will help.
Michael and saying, yes, love that eye. You know, Michael and do you do mixed media, don't you? Because with your same first scares you. I did an experiment earlier in the year. My son, he's a grown up, but he's a gamer, and he wanted us to do a Magamaya, an animal off one of his games. And what I used for the fur on that was sawdust, and it worked really, really well.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah.
Yeah. Sawdust, it really looks like fur painted over it. I love it. Still haven't changed the background. It needs to have an icy background. I need to do that on it before it's finished.
Michael Ann is an incredible artist. You have to check out some of her
stuff.
Oh,
she is. Yeah.
Gosh, just incredible.
I'm over the moon. She started posting her art again.
See, I'm going to have to go look because, you know, the thing about Instagram and all those things is that they don't give you the things you want to see, you know?
Yeah.
All right, I got to draw the tongue because it's on the bottom.
So. Now that I know that about Instagram, if I haven't seen someone post for a while and they post, I click on the name and go to their page so I can see if I've missed any.
That's really smart. I don't even think about, like, it's just out of sight, out of mind, you know?
I'm sitting here with my jaw hanging open because Michael Ann's saying thanks because we love our art. She's saying, but I don't think I am. Are you serious, lady? You're an amazing artist.
Yeah, like, for real. Not just blowing smoke or trying to make you feel good.
No, not blowing smoke at all. Wow. Hey, we're all our own worst critics, aren't we?
I guess
no,
so.
No, we love seeing your work, Michael, and if you've got more, post it up, please. You're welcome. She's saying, wow, thank you. It's true, though. I remember the first time I saw some art of yours was your colored pencil turtle, tortoise.
Yes, that's what I was, exactly what I was thinking of too.
Uh-huh, and that is just phenomenal.
I totally agree.
The shading, the size, everything's in proportion. The shading's amazing, the face is amazing. And then what you put up last week, the black and white portrait. I love that.
I'm going to have to look. I don't know what you're talking about.
I just put a couple of pieces up last week. I'll get them up on my phone and I'll tag you.
Okay. Now I got to shape this so it doesn't look like it's sticking straight down. Because it's not.
Yeah. There's some that I've missed on Michael Ann's. Wow. This was back in August. I've liked it, so I must be saying it. You've got some brilliant stuff on there, Michael Ann. Oh, wow. Right, I'll tag you in the face one, Heather.
Thank you. Anybody ever wants me to see something they've done, they really should just tag me, because honestly, that's the best thing to do. I love getting that, though, too. Oh, that reminds me. A lady who saw a couple years ago, I did that nativity. It's just the Mary and Joseph with the baby.
Yeah.
And, you know, the no faces, just whatever. And I, you know, gave the drawing out to those who were watching and the patrons, remember? But she was inspired by that. And so she's doing, like, she's teaching a class, like a choir paint along thing with her church.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So she tagged me. That was pretty cool. Okay. So now I'm going to go back to this here. I can make that a little bigger. It needs to be.
Michael and Sin, you guys are making me smile. Love yous. We Aww. Love you too.
Yeah. It's warranted. It's not, it's truly not to
oh, yeah. make you think. Credit where it's due.
Yeah.
No BS here. Got an amazing stalk on the Instagram as well. Is it a stalk or a crane? Should have read the description.
That she drew?
Yeah, well, painted. Is it in acrylics, Michael Ann? It looked acrylic. I'll go back on. I've got a. I shouldn't have said anything until I had the proper details. Me rambling on as usual.
That's all right.
Oh, it was a tutorial of the Frugal Crafter.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah. It doesn't say what bird it is, but it's a water bird. It's white. It's got a long beak, long legs. Love it. Got quite a few faces on. Really good.
I feel like this is just not the right.
You're really good at faces, Michael Ann.
Let's fix that. Under there. I erase this part is what I'll do, and that'll help. Yeah. Need a brush. Oh. Good thing that'll cover that up.
It was Michael Ann, it was last year. It's a white bird. And then I went down to the bottom of your page And there's an amazing flower, white flower painted. Absolutely stunning. Yeah, the black and white bird. That was done with the Lyra graphite crayon and gesso. Wow. From the it was art from the couch. That's where I do most of mine too. Jane saying such a great drawing, Heather. Oh, Richard's here. He's saying love the black on it.
Okay, that part is really white down here, so I have to put in grays to let it seem.
I think that's Sophie again.
Do you?
Mm.
With all the black and gray? I haven't filled in a lot, but so I know that that's part of it, but
that flower was your first painting, the oil paints. Has it good when you go on Michael Ann's Instagram, go down to the bottom, there's a stunning white flower. And that's just saying that's our first painting, and it's oil paint. It's absolutely stunning.
Oh, boy. Where is it?
I've never worked with oils. I don't know if I could handle the smell.
I've worked with oil pastels and I didn't really love them, so I stay away.
Oil pastels are different. They're more like glorified crayons, aren't they?
Yeah, the smell of that. And then I'm not good at cleanup, so it doesn't make any sense for me to even attempt.
It would be an expensive job for you.
Yeah, it would.
Jane's asking where I'm looking at Mike Land's art on our Instagram, Jane. Forever learning. Yeah, forever learning art. Such a cute face.
All right, back over to this eye now. And turn it just a little bit so I can ease my way into this one here. Sharpen.
Do they sharpen all right then, Heather? Do they?
Yeah, it seems to be working really well. I had to buy a new one of these, and at first I was using the old one and it wasn't working too well. So I bought a new one. And I don't know if it's because the other one broke here. So this would pop out on me all the time. And I don't know if that was the reason why, but I kept breaking lead. Right. And I bought a new one thinking, I love this pencil sharpener for my regular colored pencils.
Yeah.
But I've given it a shot again for these, and it seems to be working pretty well.
Not good.
Yeah.
I use the handheld one. I use is the Kum, the KUM. Double.
Oh.
It does a fine point, like a long sharp point.
Yeah, this one does two. You can either do.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you can see that on the edge there, but it has like this or like that.
Yeah. And I've got one of them with the hand crank on.
Oh, yeah, I've wanted one of those.
I've got the Derwent one. It works really well.
Does it?
It tends to take a lot off when you're using machines rather than handheld.
Yeah.
And I bought an electric one a couple of months ago because it was on cheap.
Uh-huh.
And I can just plug that into my computer or use it with batteries.
Oh, how cool.
Yeah. It works okay. I haven't tried it with any softer leads yet. I've only tried it with ordinary pencil. Although I have tried it with me. I get those Derwent, you know, they look like a pencil, but they're in a razor.
Mm-hmm.
And they've got a brush on the end. I like to use them for details. And the electric one sharpens that one lovely.
Well, that's good.
Been wanting to get me colored pencils out and do some on that hibiscus I did a couple of weeks ago because I'm not happy with it.
The hibiscus?
Yeah.
Why not?
I got too much color on the edges. It's too dark. So I'm planning on working with my pencils with it and try and make it more 3D if I can.
Okay.
I'm not happy with it, so I might as well play about with it, see if I can be happy with it.
Yeah, that's true. I think it's funny how you know, we all get like that, where we're like, I know that I could do something different, and this is not what I was after. There's nothing wrong with it, per se. It's just not what I was aiming to achieve.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of times we say, you know, yeah, and I don't like it. But that's not the same as I'm not happy with it. I think I could do better.
Yeah.
And a lot of times we get down on ourselves, or people around us get upset with us because we're not happy with what we've done. You got to stop that. You know, I hear that a lot from you and Lynn's.
Yeah.
But it's just listening to you talk about it, and I'm thinking, oh, this must be what they go through when they're telling me something. And so that ain't good.
No.
That is not good right there. This is the first time I've had one of these do this. That does not make me happy.
No, it doesn't.
A broken lead or whatever in the stick of the pencil always irritates me. Oh, it always irritates me. Remember, if that's for me, you take a message. I'm really busy right now, okay?
Well, it is international.
Well,
that's what comes up on the phone. I've had them a lot this week, international ones.
Oh, I was reading an article. It said scammers did not take a holiday. I guess because they assumed everybody's at home on the holiday, they started calling even worse than usual.
Yeah. I get them in fits and starts. I can get up to six a day, up till 9 o'clock at night.
At least they stop, I guess.
Weeks, and then I get nothing for weeks, and then start again. Michael Ann saying bummer about the broken lid.
Yeah, it's a bummer. But we'll just move on. No big deal.
Hopefully that was just a little weak bit. The rest of it's okay.
That's what I'm hoping too, because this is my black, my carbon black. I will be using this one quite a bit, so let's not be broken, please.
Look at that face.
Okay. Andrew's saying, they certainly didn't drive this crazy yesterday. I know. I read an article about it saying that they didn't, it was all over the place, not any one isolated area. All right, I'm going to switch to my darker gray for this part.
If you hear a ding-dong or a knock, I'll have to go for a couple of minutes because I'm waiting for a parcel.
Yeah. Hey, we pause for parcels. That's fine. I went ahead and ordered the gear for the Google Home stuff for Graham.
Watching Graham.
Yeah. I'm very excited. Did I tell you she got another visitor?
What, another one after Monday?
No, Monday. So I did tell you she got a visitor on Monday. Okay, good. Because I can't remember who I said it to or whatever. But yeah, so that was like the straw that broke the camel's back. And all my family was like, yeah, that's a great idea. Let's do that.
Yeah.
So they're helping pay for most of it. So that's good.
Good. You can't put a price on peace and security.
No. And you know, and I'm excited, too, about her being able to just say, you know, call Heather. And it will chime and ding and let me know.
Yeah.
To talk with her. Because several times she has a question for me. And so she thinks, well, I'm not going to bother her on the phone. And to her, it doesn't seem like it's that big of a deal, but then she comes walking down here. Yeah. And it's not a big deal that she walks down here. I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying I don't want her down here. What I'm saying is, then she's down here. And now she's like, oh, maybe I shouldn't have walked down to the apartment. And she'll forget her cane.
Yeah.
You know, and then it's like this major hassle to get her back up there. And then the whole time she's like, I guess I shouldn't have come down, you know, like, no, really, you should have just called. But, you know, I don't want her to feel like she can't wander around her own property, but she doesn't do it safely. That's the frustrating part.
Yeah. No, after that scare you had with Grams a couple of years ago with the door-to-door salesman. I'm not surprised you're pulling out all the stops after what happened Monday.
Yeah, too many. And we've had a couple of, you know, people come by. She says, oh, I had another visitor today, and like it's no big deal. And of course, you know, she says, well, they seem nice. I'm sure nothing's wrong. This is a very nice guy. Well, con men are nice. That's their job. It's their job to be nice.
It is.
They wouldn't be able to get anybody's money if they weren't nice.
Does it seem to be happening a lot more, do you think, these days?
Well, I think they can tell. I mean, if they just look and watch, they can tell that this person lives alone.
Yeah, it's too easy for them to watch.
The car never leaves. I mean, there's a whole... There's a whole, you know, ecosystem about what goes on that kind of gives them a clue.
Yeah. And con men are con men because they're good at reading people.
Yep.
Dying to know whose dog it is. It's cute as anything.
Well, I may have messed up the nose a little bit, so I'm kind of bummed about that right at the moment. But Maybe I can bring it back.
Don't forget your canoe rays.
Yeah, I know. And I'm trying to get the shadow that's underneath here. Here's what's cool about pastels is that you can go over. So it's not like you know, kind of like with acrylics. You make a mistake with acrylics and you can kind of fix it.
So it's a lot more forgiving than you would expect.
Yeah. Yeah, and on this pastel mat, I mean, come on. It's like even more so.
Yeah.
This stuff is just really good. And here's what I'm learning as we're going back to our conversation earlier about not wanting to mess up on the paper and knowing it's expensive and just not feeling comfortable enough to necessarily do, just jump into it or whatever.
Yeah.
What I'm finding is when I do use better stuff, my results are better. So it makes me want to do more once I've done something well, you know?
Yeah. Jane's saying, whose sweet little doggy is this? She's not letting us know, Jane. We've got to guess.
Okay. And I'm thinking I'm going to lay in this darker, real soft. This is the only thing I don't love about colored pencils is this like larger area.
Yeah.
You know, having to fill in a larger area. Like, that's what I love about pan pastels. And I could try to do pan pastels, but it's been my experience that I can't use this paper, these pencils, over pan pastels. I don't know if that's all pastel pencils, because I've seen people who have done pastel pencils over pan pastel on pastel mat, but I wasn't able to do it with these Derwents, and that kind of bums me out because I was really looking forward to being able to do that, specifically why I wanted the pastel pencils in the first place, you know.
Yeah.
Which I should mention again, this paper and these pencils were fabulous gifts from viewers. Jules with the paper and Michael and Andrew with the pencils. So thanks, guys.
You're welcome. We get the pleasure of seeing you use them and the wonderful art you make. Oh, look at that.
So now this helps with the like salt and pepper gray. So now we've got like, I'm concentrating more on where the darker spots are. And then since we didn't fill in with color, I'm able to give the appearance of that tufted fur, you know, it looks like.
On the top of the head there, it already looks like it's all tufted and you can see the rows of fur.
Yeah, that was just real lightly using the pencil in more of a shaded. And then, you know, going in the different directions allows it to look a little bit more like his fur, too. So I gotta fill in on this. Eyes.
So much life in the eyes. I've just had a thought whose dog it could be. I'm not saying.
Goes right here.
Andrew's off to you. To you. Have fun, Andrew. Oh, I missed a comment Andrew made. Oh, no, I did say it. So you've had storms there again, Heather.
Yeah, but it looks like it's all cleared up. It's lots of gray out there, but no water is falling at the moment.
Right.
That part's good.
I didn't know what had happened, but when I saw you put the map on Instagram, I thought, oh no, she better not be walking about in that lake last time.
I know you said that. Oh, that's too funny.
Well, you nearly got washed away last time.
Well, I mean, we had little bursts, you know.
Yeah. So what is it about drawing animals that you think it works best? What's the formula for you?
Well, I think that it's about I don't know, that's a hard question to answer because I think what I'm experiencing while I'm doing these is thinking about the person who you know, if I know the person who this is their, you know, it's their love.
Yeah.
And I know how much they love and appreciate this being in their life and thinking about them and trying to make them happy is good. I've drawn horses, like, you know, I've tried to just draw a horse because I like horses and I thought it would be kind of cool to challenge myself to do a horse and it didn't turn out so good and I didn't really enjoy it and, you know, but it wasn't connected to anyone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I really think that's the biggest difference to me is
the connection,
that connection. And so, there's that. And then there's also the challenge of, now, how do I make this look like it's dimensional? How do I make it look like in the image, I can see his nose is definitely closer to me, and then all the eyes are back set further. How do I do that on a paper that is literally flat?
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm thinking while we're talking here and going through this stuff, I'm thinking to myself, okay, does that really look like it's round? Does it really look like it's set back further than this is the eyebrow and it comes out towards me. And do I really have that? No, not yet. Okay. Then I need to go in here with some black and I really need to push this back further. Because as I go in here with the black and push a little harder, now you'll see this is definitely an eyebrow.
It is. Yeah.
It is definitely coming at us over where this eye is. And then maybe I need to darken that eye up even more just to make it really go backwards back here.
It's like magic watching
that. What it did. And that's mm-hmm. exactly what it did. So see where this one seems much more flat.
Yeah.
Like this one definitely curves back here, and then this hair is coming at us more.
It does. That was magic to watch that.
Yeah, and so we do the same thing over here. And of course, it's happening, but when you hear why it's happening, I think it helps you with your art and how you can figure out how to do the same thing. So again, yes. I'm going to go in here and darken that up real well, darken this part up real well, and then I'm going to go with this darker gray. It's called Seal. So it's not quite black, but it's not too dark or too light either. And I'm just going to give some dimension to this part of the eye while watching my reference, because I don't want to change his character. I don't want to change his expression, which, you know, I know they don't have eyelashes like you and I have eyelashes. They don't have, mm-hmm. you know, that we see dogs smile, but they're not really smiling. They're just lifting up that portion of their face. We call it smiling.
Yeah.
So we have all these little things that make them look like characters and show their personality, and you can see it. So you don't want to ruin any of that. So how do we do that? We just add a little bit of dark where it needs to go backwards a little bit more.
So you're just adding that little bit you've done there, it's brought it forward a bit more.
Yeah, and then we're going to do the same thing in here because this needs to go in a little bit more so it's not so flat. We'll just add some depth in here. And again, trying to stay in character of this little guy that I'm not giving his name out still.
Going to tease us till the end.
Well, yeah, because if it's not him and nobody can tell, then I'm certainly not going to tell you that's who it is. I'll make somebody else's dog's name.
Michael Anson, adorable. I agree. Melissa says she's doing a video tomorrow on YouTube.
That's awesome, Melissa. Good job.
Yeah.
Get out there, girl.
What you gonna be doing? What time you doing it?
Let's see, just trying to see where I want to go down here. This is a lot of white fur around the bottom of the mouth, like a little white beard.
Oh, Melissa doesn't know what time. I will look for it. Or tag us on Instagram before you go live and we'll come and join you if we're capable of it.
little bit of that color is coming around here.
And this is saying she'll probably post it on Instagram. It's a good thing to do. Let us know that you're going to go live.
Yeah, that's good. Very good.
Look at that face.
Okay.
Get lost in the depth of them eyes.
Keep going here. Can't believe I don't have the left side of the face done at all. There's still a lot to do here. We might just pause this and come back to it on Monday. That actually might be the best plan.
You're the boss.
I really think I might do that because I don't like what I did with the nose here. I feel like I lost the shape. That it had. So I think I need to erase this part here. But there's a lot on there, so I don't know if it's just going to move it around.
Jane's asking, is it one of Sandra's dogs?
Nope, it is not.
That was my first guess, Jane.
It was her first guess. Much smaller. So let's see. I'm just going to see if I can't get this part of the nose the way I want it to be.
So if it's smaller than Sandra's dogs, it must be more on the size of Jane's dog, Sophie. But I don't know anybody who's got a dog as small as Sophie.
Even a little smaller.
Even smaller than Sophie, wow.
Mm-hmm.
No idea then. Jane says, so darn cute. I totally agree. There you go. Yeah. Did that do and what you wanted?
Very much so.
Yeah.
Very much so.
Yeah, I see what you meant now, because it looked fine to me.
Just a little more shape. Oh, how stinking cute.
It is.
Yep. Looking good. All right, so we'll finish it up on Monday. I think that's what we'll do. I love it.
Gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous.
That's a good place to stop too, because I can definitely tell this is the dog I'm trying to draw.
Good.
But I don't want to tell you who it is. So you'll have to tune in Monday to find out who is this puppy. And thanks everybody for spending the day after Thanksgiving with me. And we should be back to regular schedule next week. I know Grandma has some things she wants to do, some birthday things that she wants to do next week, but I'm going to try really hard to get her to do them after my show is over. So,
all right.
As long as everything goes as planned. So thanks everybody for being here, and we'll catch you next time. We're going to do those Instagram shout outs before we go live starting Monday. Okay.
Thank you
very
everyone.
Much, Jules, for being here. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And we will catch you next time.
Bye-bye. Hello.